Hello, friends. Imagine your computer and internet are like a fortress, and you want to make sure no sneaky intruders can get in. Threat hunting is like having expert security guards who actively patrol your fortress to find and stop any potential intruders before they can cause harm. In the world of computers and internet, there are cyber criminals who want to steal your data, disrupt your online life, or even cause damage. They use tricky methods to sneak past regular security measures like antivirus and firewalls. That's where threat hunting comes in. Instead of waiting for alarms to go off when something bad happens, threat hunters actively look for clues and signs that might show a cyber intruder is trying to get in. They use special tools and their knowledge to search for anything unusual, like footprints in the snow. For example, if someone tries to sneak in through a hidden door of your fortress, the threat hunters would spot those footprints and act quickly to stop the intruder. Threat hunting is like having digital detectives who search for hidden threats, investigate them, and keep your digital world safe. It's an essential part of keeping your online life secure in a world where cyber threats are always evolving. These are the modern risks of our current digital space, and as you know, modern risks require modern strategies. Welcome to Whiteboard Security, a channel where I explain cybersecurity concepts using examples and stories. If you enjoy the content, please hit the subscribe button to stay updated. With all these risks, this is where threat hunting comes in. If you aspire to work in a security operations center, the following techniques, methodologies, and strategies are the basics of threat hunting. And if you want to increase your threat hunting results, then becoming familiar with the MITRE ATT&CK strategies is the best starting point. Explaining all the threat hunting techniques would turn this video into a couple of hours, so I will mention some of the common techniques out there. First, sandboxing or sandbox analysis. Imagine you have a special magical playground called a sandbox. In this sandbox, you can test things to see if they are safe or not. Sometimes people send you mysterious toys or games, but you're not sure if they are good or bad. Sandbox analysis is like taking those mysterious toys and playing with them in your magical sandbox. You can watch how they act and what they do, but you don't need to worry about them making a mess or breaking your favorite toys outside the sandbox. If the mysterious toy starts doing something weird or naughty in the sandbox, you can see it without any harm. Then you can tell the cybersecurity experts what the toy is up to. They will decide if it's safe or if they need to make sure it doesn't come out of the sandbox and cause any trouble. This is exactly how sandboxing is applied in threat hunting. Sandboxes are isolated environments where files or code can be executed safely for analysis. Threat hunters can submit suspicious files or URLs to sandbox to understand their behavior without risking the organization's network. Next, we have threat intelligence feeds, also known as threat feeds or threat intelligence sources. Imagine you have a secret club and you want to know if any troublemakers are planning to do something naughty in your club. Threat intelligence feeds are like secret messages that tell you about the naughty plans of those troublemakers. These messages tell you their plans and any tricks they might use to break into your club. Technically, subscribing to threat intelligence feeds provides threat hunters with up-to-date information on known threats, attack techniques, and indicators of compromise. They use this information to proactively search for these threats in their environment. The final technique we mention in this video is implementing honeybots and decoys. Honeybots are like digital traps, and decoys are like distractions. For honeybots, imagine you have a treasure chest, but instead of holding real treasures, it's just a pretend one. The catch is that it looks so real that when a sneaky pirate comes along, they can't resist trying to steal it. In the digital world, a honeybot is a fake computer system or network that looks tempting to hackers. When a hacker tries to break in, cybersecurity experts watch closely to learn about the hacker's tactics and protect the real systems from similar attacks. As for decoys, think of a magician who creates many fake objects to distract your attention while they perform a trick. In the digital world, decoys are like these distractions. They are fake digital assets, such as fake files or servers, meant to divert cyber attackers' attention away from the real, valuable targets. When hackers go after these decoys, it gives cybersecurity experts time to catch them and protect the actual important stuff. So, in simple terms, honeybots are like digital traps that lure hackers in, while decoys are like distractions that keep hackers busy, allowing cybersecurity experts to catch them or protect the real digital assets. Thank you so much for watching this video all the way to the end. I hope you found the information helpful and informative. If you enjoyed this content and found it valuable, please consider giving it a thumbs up by hitting the like button below. If you think others could benefit from this information, don't forget to share this video with your friends and colleagues. For more insightful content and to stay up to date on the latest cybersecurity topics and insights, please hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you won't miss any of our future videos. Your support means a lot, and it helps me create quality content. I look forward to sharing more knowledge with you in the future. Thanks again for watching. Stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one.